Hello everyone, welcome. This is a new lesson and today we are going to talk about the modifiers. Modifiers is very important and here in the tab you have a lot of modifiers. We will talk today about array and bevel and boolean. So how we can add an array? So it's very simple. You can click array and it will make another replicate. You can increase it and it's animatable. Any value in the modifiers or any in this bare vertex, it can be animate. So you can add a value for the camera to be moved, or you can animate this and it will be correctly. Here is the offset. This is the distance between any object. As you can see, it's now contact with each other. You can increase this distance. If you want it to be constant, so you can add here a constant offset to be around 3 meter. You can also add another array to be maybe 4 in this direction, and it's displayed correctly. Add another array in the Z, 2 meter, only 3 or maybe 2, and it's displayed such as this. You can add any modifiers as you want. The next is that we want to talk about the bevel. So you can add bevel and it will bevel and add bevel to all your objects. What is interesting about this modifier, it is that you can add segment as you want, or you can change the amount, or you can change the shading and add material for this edge. So this is material number 0, maybe plastic. I assume that is in the viewport it will be shown in red. But we have another material which is metal, which is shown in blue. And I want to make the bevel to be 1. So as you can see, the bevel will be the metal which is blue. Anyway, the amount of bevel can be defined as you want. It can be large or it can be small as you want. You can change this value. What next? Which is the boolean? So you can add a cylinder, select the cube and add boolean. Select the object which is a cylinder, or you can pick from here. We have 3 options. Difference will make a difference. As you can see, it make a hole here. Let's apply to see what is the difference. If you hide it, you will see that we have the hole here. Anyway, I will scale and move in y axis, rotate around x 90 degrees, and move down here. You can select both or select one object and add boolean and select union. Then it's time to select the cylinder and make it union. It's now one object. I just go in y axis, so it's better now. I will apply to see what is the result. So this is our result, and the final one, which is, I assume that you have a sphere and we have another sphere. And if we select one to and add the boolean modifier and go to the sphere, it will be the intersect which is here, and I want to apply now. So let's see what we have. So this is the intersection of both spheres. Alright, next we talk. We should talk about the mirror modifier. Here is an object, and I want to mirror in the z-axis. How we can achieve that? I will select all vertex and assign the cursor here. Go object mode and set origin to the CD cursor, and go to the mirror modifier. We can select axis to be z, and here we are. Not x, only the z axis, and you should apply it to see the result. We have also the screw modifier. How we can achieve that? Let's try to add an plane. And extrude a few time here, and if you add the screw modifier, you will see that it make this shape, and as you can see, it's editable, so you can add as you want. Just check the axis, and it's now will work, so it can be merged. Or so iteration. This is the angle. And if you want to screw, you can add the screw. And again, we have an cube, and we can add the subdivision surface. So you add subdivision surface, you make it smooth. You can make it more in the viewport, and this will be the render. Typically, it should not be more than 4. Usually, I make it in the viewport 2, and in the render 2x3. Assume that is you have this circle, and you want to add thickness to it. As you can see, it's now have no thickness. I will add the solidify, and it should now add thickness to our sphere. It's in this direction or in this direction, and maybe 0.25, and you have now added thickness. What we have next, you have the modifier. So I will check wireframe. And it should make this wireframe, just change the thickness, and it should add the wireframe to you. So we have finished this lesson. I hope you enjoy this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.